Okay, let's see. Okay, it works. Yay!
Yeah, you gotta keep it close.
Okay. All right. If I do that again, just yell at me. And I'm not used to having a mic. So thank you for that introduction. Like Jim said, I am Breanne Wright. I work in the archives of the City of Kingsport. And I know a lot of you are probably familiar with the archives, or at least hopefully know that Kingsport has an archives. I'm going to give just a quick little rundown of what the archives does. So, first off, what is an archives? I'm not going to read all of that, but basically, for our purposes, the archives here is where we keep archival records. Okay, so how do archives differ from libraries? Some of the main things are with the type of materials. Archives usually have one-of-a-kind, rare, specialized materials. There's usually a wider range of materials than a normal library. Most of the stuff is unpublished, and there's limited access to the archives. You can't come in and just browse the shelves like you could in the library. Nothing in the archives can be checked out. And then there's also sometimes restrictions on access or reproduction. So, and the mission of the archives, and this is not specific necessarily to Kingsport, this is kind of mission of most archives, but it's to identify, collect, appraise, protect, preserve, house, describe, and make accessible records of enduring or archival value. And what does that mean? So, archival value is basically long-term, continuous historical information for present and future generations. And there's all sorts of classifications when it comes to valuing records. None of this really pertains to the Kingsport archives necessarily. I should have just kept that slide out. but one thing I did want to note on here is a lot of times I get asked to appraise different materials. The archives does not do that. So if someone calls and asks how much something may be worth, which happens quite a bit actually, I'm not allowed to tell them. So I always point them in the direction of someone who can. Okay, so collection and appraisal in the archives. I'm gonna switch this. what we decide that is kept in the archives, there's different, I'm drawing a blank here. Yeah, there's different criteria, basically. What the material is, the condition of it. Unfortunately, a lot of times things come to the archives in horrible condition, and it's not salvageable necessarily. And then also the value and the uniqueness of the materials. And the biggest thing is just because it's old doesn't mean it belongs in the archives. That's a common misconception, I think, that people have. They call and they ask to donate old magazines or whatever, but that's just not, we can't take everything, which, I'm gonna go to the collection policy specific to the Kingsport Archives. Is basically we collect materials that are relevant to the history of Kingsport. So people call up and they say, oh, I have some old Life magazines or whatever. I don't want them. They do not belong in our archives here for Kingsport, unless there's an article about something related to Kingsport. But for the most part, anything to do with Kingsport history is what we will take. So a little bit about the archives. It's been around since 1994. It was the first municipal archive in Tennessee. There's over 800 different collections, over 5,000 images on our website, and right now it's located in the basement of the library, but we're moving, so, and I'll swing back around to that here in a minute. And there's, it's different, even though it's in the library, it's acts as its own department, and there's different hours, and there's only one person on staff. So again, just sort of going back to like what I find appropriate for the archives, you know, is it Kingsport related? Do we have the space? What condition? And will it be useful in the future? So the archives is sort of separated out two different collection types. We have the community collections, which are donated by people, businesses, different organizations like the Kiwanis Club. We actually have a Kiwanis Club collection. So those are the community collections. The municipal collections are things that come to the archives from different departments within the city government. So, but the community collections is really where the archive shines. That's the bulk of what we've got. That's the real fun stuff. Not that the city stuff isn't fun, but it's not as exciting necessarily. So what can you find in the Kingsport Archives? As you can see, tons of different things. We have, you know, huge photograph collections, photograph negative collections, yearbooks, pretty much any kind of material you can think of, we have it. We have some film, some audio tapes, and various memorabilia here and there. The archives, we don't tend to take a lot of artifacts necessarily because we're not a museum. There are exceptions to that. It just kind of depends. It's a case-by-case basis. For instance, one person came in, they wanted to donate a Soapbox Derby car, and they said, if you don't take it, I'm going to throw it away or take it to the dump. And I was like, well, I'll take it then, even though there's not really a whole lot of room. But funny enough, since that time, there's been another one donated. So I don't know. I can't turn them down. I mean, they're too cool. But and they're great for when kids come and tour the library and they come down to the archives. That's the biggest thing that stands out to them are those Soapbox Derby cars. Let's see. So as Jim said, I am pretty passionate about the archives. I think it's one of the most underrated departments, I think, in the city. But I, you know, I love preserving the history. I love sharing it with people. So, you know, archives matter. They matter to me. They matter, you know, I think to the community. There's a lot of fantastic things that come out from having an archives. And I will say, I don't think people realize sometimes how great our archives is here in the city. We're a relatively new city compared to a lot of other places, and we have a really good collection of things. And so I get excited about sharing it. I guess I'm a little biased that I work with this stuff, but really, Kingsport's really lucky that we have such a good archives that the community have donated things over the years because for instance, going back to our centennial, we had tons of information available for all sorts of different programs, outreach. You know, we're really lucky. We weren't scrambling to try to find stuff. So I find it very important because here's just a quick little thing about memory and why it's so important to have documentation like the photos and different documents and everything, oral histories, you know. Because memory can change. It's very biased, very selective. And so you really can't trust someone's memory. So it's good to have actual evidence of things that have happened, or basically proof that something happened, someone existed. And then, so like I said, the community stuff, that is all donated by individuals. Everything that comes into the archives is donated. We don't have a budget to purchase anything for the archives. So it's really important for the community to keep donating to the archives. And a big thing here lately is I ask people, who else wants your stuff? A lot of people are downsizing right now. They're going through things, and you know, a lot of stuff, you know, your kids, your grandkids, they probably don't really want to go through, you know, your stuff. So I tell people before that happens, you know, you can bring it to the archives and I can determine whether or not it would be a good fit for the archives. But and so that's been a big thing here in the last few years, people downsizing and they don't know what to do with it. So, and I always tell people too, if they aren't sure if the archives would actually want their stuff, that the best thing they can do before they start throwing things away is just bring it to me and I can go through it and figure out what to do with it. And then, of course, I'm not going to read all of that, but there are advantages to donating stuff to an actual archives. You know, they're taken care of. It's a safe, secure facility. You know, we monitor temperature, humidity. Right now, with it being in the basement of the library, a lot of people have thought over the years that that's not the best place for the archives to be. Because of possible flooding, or you know, how do you maintain the humidity and temperature? But actually, the environment down there, we've had a few issues over the years, but for the most part, the temperature, humidity, everything is monitored, and it's actually a good environment for the materials for the most part. Okay, so I feel like I'm moving really quickly through this, but ways to access the archives other than actually just coming to the archives to visit. We have our website that's part of the Kingsport Library's website. On here you can find, like I said earlier, there's over 5,000 images on there, all relating to Kingsport. So, and then we also have what are called finding aids. Basically it's an index of what is in different collections. So if you were to pull up the website, do a search for Dobbins Bennett, it will bring up everything we have on Dobbins Bennett that has been put online. It wouldn't be everything, because not everything's digitized. I tell people the best place to start if they're looking for information is going to be on the website. And then, especially within the last year or so with COVID and everything, the emphasis has been a lot on outreach. So the archives actually has a lot of different social media channels. Some of them I don't really keep up with too much, but like I'm always posting on Facebook. That's a good way to keep up with any kind of news. And then I think these are fun. I don't know if you all are familiar with SoundCloud, but I was able a while back to digitize some cassette tapes and actually some vinyl records. And so those files are on there for anybody to check out. And I think they're really cool. And then YouTube has different 16 millimeter, 8 millimeter film that we've digitized over the years. So those are cool to check out. Okay, so let's go back to the archives is moving. These are not the best pictures necessarily, but I'm so excited. The archives is moving into the new City Hall, which I'm just like super overjoyed about. After being down in the basement for over 13 years, I have a window. So it is fabulous. Like it's made a huge difference. But so my office is currently moved. Everything is set up. So I've been working out of the new City Hall building. The other stuff, the actual collections and everything, have not made the move yet. And I'm not sure when that'll actually happen. But, and again, these are not really the best pictures to represent the space that is over there, but it is a fantastic space for the archives. Not only are we gonna have a really nice like reading room for patrons to come in and do research. And I don't know how many of you have been in the current archives. It's kind of, you know, dark and it's just not very inviting. It's small. There's not really a good place for people to come in and do a lot of research. I think one time I had like 4 patrons come in at the same time and I'm scrambling trying to figure out where do I put them, you know, because it's like there's only so much room in there. So this new space is going to be fantastic, and I'm so excited for patrons to be able to actually hopefully feel more comfortable in this space. And the shelving, the top there, that last picture, right now, of course, it's just one big open room. That's going to be like the record storage room. So that's where all the collections, everything are going to go. And I'm never thought I'd be so excited about shelves. But when I was meeting with the guy and we were talking about what was needed in this facility, I mentioned, you know, man, I'm really excited about these shelves. And he said, no one's ever said that before. I'm like, but no, you don't understand. Like, this is so exciting because what I love about this in this blank space is the shelving is going to be more custom to what we have currently and what we might get in the future. Whereas now the shelves were put in and then collections started being put on them. With this, we talked about different art racks and oversized shelving. And there's even going to be shelving specific for those soapbox derby cars. So, you know, it's really exciting for not just me and the community, but like this space will function a lot better, I think, since it's really been thought about what needs to go in there and what's best. And you can't really tell, but one of these rooms is going to be a processing room, which is basically just going to be a big work area, which I'm also very excited about because the space I have right now in the basement is, it's just hard. You know, it's really crammed in there. There's not a lot of space to work on like big items. And so overall, I think it's just going to be really great, a really great space. So I'm excited when the move is finally going to be done. It's been a long time coming. So, okay. And my fan club are actually the Friends of the Archives. They are a nonprofit organization that anyone can join. They do different things to help support the archives. They volunteer, provide interns, do all sorts of stuff. So if you have any interest in joining the Friends, feel free to ask about it. And thank you. So, yeah, questions?